A very warm good morning to all my dear students. Today in this EVS module, our new chapter is chapter 18, the environment around us. Children, all living things are natural things that are present in the environment. For example, plants, animals, sun, wind, etc. Natural things are divided into living things and non-living things. Plants, animals, and human beings are living natural things, whereas sun, wind, air, and water are non-living natural things. In this chapter, let us learn about the relationship between living organisms and the environment. Interdependence of life. All living things depend on their environment to supply them with what they need, including food, water, and shelter. This is known as interdependence of life. For example, human beings eat food in the form of plants and animals. Animals eat plants or other small animals. Birds eat plants, worms, and insects. Worms and insects eat plants and grass. Plants get food from the sun, water, and soil. So thus we see that all living things depend on other living and non-living things for their survival. Children, let's understand more the interdependence of life through this picture. As you can see in this image, that the nutrients along with sun and water cause the grass to grow. Then the grasshopper eat the plants. After that, the mice eat the grasshopper. Then the snakes eat the mice. After that, the eagle eat the snake. When the hawks die, fungus breaks the bodies down and turns them into nutrients. And again, this circle complete and start with the sun one more time. So what we understood, that how plants, animals, birds, and insects need each other for food and water. The grass gets energy from the sun, and the grasshopper is able to eat it and live. Similarly, the snake gets its food only if the birds, frogs, and mice live by eating the grasshopper, right? This dependence of living and non-living natural things on each other makes a web of life. Now, let's talk about food chain. Children, a food chain is a sequence of who eats whom. A food chain usually starts with the sun. A food chain also shows how the organisms are related with each other by the food they eat. A simple food chain, for example, links grass to grasshoppers that are food for frogs and birds, which in turn are food for snakes, and so on. Each link in this chain is food for the next link. Here, green plants produce food for all human beings and herbivorous animals. Hence, green plants are the only producers of food on Earth. All the living beings, including humans, animals, and other creatures, are consumers of food, as they cannot produce food like green plant. Imbalance in the food chain. Children, what do you do when you feel hungry? You eat some food, right? Don't you? But have you thought what would happen if all the food in the world were to get over? Or when there are 10 hungry grasshoppers for a small quantity of grass? Well, this is what will happen. If there is a less grass and more grasshoppers, there will be less grass for them to eat, okay? And some will die of hunger, obviously. Because of this, there will be fewer grasshoppers for the frogs as well and birds to eat. And similarly, if there will be fewer frogs and birds for the snakes to eat. Thus, some snakes will die and their numbers will decrease. When snakes become less in number, what will happen? There will be less food for the owls and hawks, and hence they too will die of hunger. Thus, due to less grass than grasshoppers, the entire food chain is affected. Right. When something like this happens, when food in the world is limited, what will happen? Then there is an imbalance in the food chain. So this imbalance tells us that not only are all plants and animals dependent on each other, but also it's very important to maintain a balance in the web of life. So in short, we can see the effects of imbalance in the food chain. When one of the link in a food chain is no longer present, the food chain breaks. Sometimes this can cause other animals in the food chain to disappear as well, and the whole ecosystem can become imbalanced. Let's take a glance at what we learned through this module. On Earth, we see both natural and man-made things. Plants, animals, sun, rain, wind, soil, etc. are natural things. Natural things can be classified into living and non-living natural things. Plants and animals are living natural things, while sun, water, wind, and soil are non-living natural things. All living things depend on living and non-living things for their survival. We also understood that the food chain is a sequence of who eats whom. A food chain shows how each living thing gets its food. So there is an interdependence of things in the environment. That's all for today. Thank you, everyone.